All right, great day to visit the South Florida Fair. We saw that. Our own Mike Lyons is there enjoying the rides, the games, and the food, and the crowd.
And Mike, we understand, speaking of food, that you plan to eat some crickets.
It is. It's time to eat some chocolate-covered crickets, and we're going to talk to the man who invented this little exotic food in just a second. But there's a close-up look at the little delicacy that I'm about to eat. Yeah, it was a challenge on our Facebook page. If we reached a certain number, and I'm told we did, then yours truly would chow down on chocolate-covered crickets. By the way, it's a beautiful night here at the South Florida Fair. The weather for the next couple of days looks great. We'll talk more about that in just a second. But now, it's time to introduce the man who created this taste sensation. This is George Sanderford, and you created the chocolate-covered crickets because...
Wow factor. How wild and crazy could I be? I got challenged, and that's what I came up with.
You were challenged originally by folks in California at their state fair, and in addition to the crickets, you came up with some other taste sensations?
Yeah, we did. Last year, we came up with a maggot melt sandwich. It's like a patty melt with maggots on it, and the crickets have been a big success, scorpions, maggots, the whole bit.
And people buy this and enjoy it here at the South Florida Fair?
Yeah, a little challenge to start with, but now they're doing. Now we've got them coming up and repeat customers.
All right, now I was told that the crickets that you get are farm-raised. They're already pre-cooked, so they're ready to go, right?
Yes, they're all come baked, ready for us to put on a sandwich or whatever we want to do with them.
And then you basically heat up some chocolate, you cover it, and then you chow down.
And you chow down.
All right, I think it's time to chow down. George, go ahead. Show us how we do it. We've got the crickets all ready to go. You pour the chocolate. And by the way, this chocolate is nice and warm, and then you just take a fork, right, and dive in, right? There we go. Right, I'm gonna get some more here. Hold on. Not bad.
Not bad at all.
Not something you'd want every day.
No, but chocolate kind of takes the taste away from it.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. All right, George. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks very much for coming over. Yeah, it's really not that bad. Actually, I'm going to have some more here in a second, but let's do a little weather, shall we? Take a look outside. Our satellite view continuing to show mostly clear skies on a beautiful night here in South Florida. If you're coming to the South Florida Fair tonight, excuse me, I got a cricket in my teeth here. If you're coming to the South Florida Fair tonight, temperatures will be dropping into the 60s, and we're expecting just a great night with clear skies. Tomorrow and all the way through the rest of the weekend, temperatures will continue to warm up, and as we head toward the first part of next week, temperatures about 80 degrees or higher. So a beautiful night in South Florida. In fact, here it is, your 7-day forecast, which continues to call for sunny, dry conditions in the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. You know, Victor and Tiffany, I had a dental appointment today, and my dentist, Dr. Bartis, came up to me for the check. He said, I understand you're going to have some chocolate-covered crickets. And he was a little concerned about my dental health. He was afraid I might get an antennae or maybe a leg in one of my teeth.
Stop.
So Dr. Bartis and his highly trained staff are on standby right now. In fact, if there's any kind of dental emergency. And I don't think there will be. I think we're all good. And in fact...
Oh, no.
All right.
There he goes.
Yeah, we're going to have some more. Yeah, well, this is really good.
All right, Mike, I got to ask you, though, what does it taste like? I mean, does it taste like anything you've tasted before? Like, does it taste like a potato chip or what?
No, it doesn't taste like anything I've ever had before. That's for sure. But again, as George said, when you put the chocolate on it, it's all good. Just cover it in chocolate. It's fantastic.
Is true. Chocolate makes anything taste good.
And bacon. You probably should have, I guess, scheduled the teeth cleaning for after the crickets. Just a suggestion next time. All right.
Yeah,
so
I may have to go back and visit Dr. Bartis tomorrow. You're right.
We're both having crickets at 11. All right.
Okay.
Thanks, Mike.